Exercise 2.11 la first sum. So you are asked to calculate the integral 0 to 1 x plus 4 dx using the concept of limit, that is area or definite integral as the limit of a sum. This is the question. This will be the format of the question. So otherwise you can calculate it as directly, you know, you can integrate x plus 4 as x square by 2 plus 4x and apply the limits and calculate. So that is the way we do in practical situations where nothing is mentioned. But idhula vandu sollirukanga using the concept of a definite integral as the limit of a sum, you have to calculate this. So we have to go through all the steps and apply that formula and do. So here fx is x plus 4. What is to be integrated? That is fx. So it is x plus 4. And a is the lower limit and b is the upper limit. So a is 0 and b is 1. And h, the width of the every rectangle in the question is taken as b minus a by n, 1 minus 0 by n, that is 1 by n. So in the formula, we need f of a plus rh. That's there in the formula, is it not? So we calculate what is f of a plus rh. F of a is 0 plus r into h is 1 by n. So this is f of r by n. Every f of x is x plus 4. So the quantity here plus 4. So f of r by n will be the quantity r by n plus 4. Now we write the formula and substitute. So I have converted everything in terms of n. So limit h tends to 0, I'm not going to write h tends to 0. I'm going to write only n tends to infinity, because in what I'm going to write there is no h, only n is there. So what is going to become infinity, tend to infinity, is n only. And h is, when there is h, I have to write h tends to 0. When there is no h in this, I need not write h tends to 0. The quantity here is only n, so n tends to infinity. H 1 by n into sigma r from 1 to n of f of a plus rh is calculated as r by n plus 4. So it is limit n tends to infinity of 1 by n into, now we split the sigma of r by n plus sigma of 4. So a sigma is applied to the two terms separately because there is a plus sign in between them. So how do we apply the formula for all this? You please watch from here onwards, it is very crucial. So limit n tends to infinity of 1 by n into r by n is the quantity for which you are supposed to take sigma. In that only r is a changing quantity. For r only the values are from 1 to n. But n remains a fixed right now. Okay. And finally we write n tends to infinity. Straight away if you apply the value n tends to infinity, you can't get a correct answer here. So we write 1 by n, we take 1 by n outside. At the moment it is a constant for you. Into sigma r. Sigma r's formula is n into n plus 1 by 2. The next term is plus sigma 4 is to be written as 4 into sigma of 1. Sigma 1 means 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 time n times. 1 plus 1 twice is 2. 1 plus 1 plus 1 is 3. 1 plus 1 plus 1 n times is n. So we substitute for n. And this n into n plus 1 by 2, when you write, n and n cancels off. Now we rewrite everything after the cancellation, and now we are going to take 1 by n inside. So every term here should be multiplied by 1 by n. So half n plus 1 divided by n plus n and n will cancel when you multiply, only 4 is there. So this expression, now I am going to simplify further. Suppose you imagine you substitute n as infinity in this, you will get infinity by infinity. So you have to see to it that n is only in the denominator, because anything by infinity is 0. So I am dividing n by n, that is 1 plus 1 by n. And at this stage I will substitute n as infinity. So half into 1 plus 1 by infinity plus 4. This becomes 0. So it's half into 1, half. Half plus 4 is 9 by 2 square units. And if you have any doubt whether your answer is correct or wrong, you can just do the direct method of finding this definite integral. That's what I'm doing here. Integral 0 to 1 x plus 4 dx is integral 0 to 1 of x, that is x square by 2, plus integral 0 to 1 of 4, that is 4x. And then when you substitute 0 and 1, 1 square by 2 minus 0 for this, plus 4 into 1 minus 0, that remains 4. So again you get half plus 4, that is 9 by 2. So this way you can do the verification. This is not needed for the exam point of view. This is needed only for your confirmation, whether your answer is correct or not, so that after finishing the sum, if you know your answer is right, you can very comfortably move on to the next question. Otherwise, you will always be troubled and will be wanting to go back to the question and check, because any question from this exercise will come for 5 marks.